Is it normal to have to go for a touch-up? Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. Today, we're talking about the touch-up. So touch-ups and fillers and neuromodulators like Botox, it's a very normal thing. One thing I wanted to address was that people now have the perception, and it's partly through social media, through Instagram, they believe that it's a very easy thing. You go in, you get a treatment, it's always perfect, and nothing ever needs to be touched up. And one of the conceptions is when things do need a touch up, it's the provider's problem or fault. One of the things that's changed 20 years ago, I used to see everyone back at 2 weeks. It was a normal thing. It's how we learned. We didn't have all the information we have today from pooling the resources. You go to a conference, there may have been 50 people there if you were lucky to pool our knowledge. Now, hundreds of people go to attend many conferences every year. You just don't go to one. So we learned a lot. We got to see back our treatments to know where we should put things. Why is it now that it's thought to be an error? Well, like I said, social media. But the other thing is that there's so many clinics to go to, people say, oh, well, Dr. So-and-so or the nurse over here didn't do a good job. I need a touch-up. I'll just go to another clinic. And they bounce around. And it's so detrimental because the provider never gets to know the anatomy and the expectations and the nuances of the specific patient. So I thought I'd go through 5 reasons of why touch-ups are necessary, and it shouldn't be something to be frustrated about. But you look at the 80% rule, and I say 80% will be perfect and don't need a touch-up of anything until their next treatment or they need to come back. About 20% would be an industry average. The people say getting lip filler or getting neuromodulator will need a touch-up or want some added or even taken away. So let's go through the 5 reasons. Number one, and something that people don't think often about, is that people now have had treatments over time. So a filler, if you're getting your second, third, or fourth filler, or neuromodulator like Botox, and you say you're getting a forehead, which is a lower dose, and you see a provider for your third or fourth time, and they look and see your movement, and they know what's there, and they treat you according to that. Some of that movement may come back weeks, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 weeks or a month or two after you left, and it looks like you need a touch-up when in reality you were treated perfect at that time. Or with a cheek filler, it was added up high, and now the filler below in 2 months is starting to go away, and so you really need that touched up. So as things wear off, it's a moving target, and so that leads to irregularities and changes in contour that one might not like. So there's one reason. Number two, especially with neuromodulators, variability of the product. So when you get a vial of Botox or one of the other ones, say there's 100 units in there, it doesn't mean there's exactly 100 units. There's some variability. We don't know what that is. We don't have that information, but there could be 90, it could be more towards 110. I think many of us believe there's variability in the vials themselves. Number three is variability of storage. Neuromodulators, most of them are temperature specific. So if you think about the FedEx truck driving around delivering them in the summer versus in the winter in temperate climates, the storage can play a role. When we get a shipment here, I'm nervous all the time that we don't miss it, or that it goes directly in the fridge or freezer. Storage and transport is a key factor and a reason why you go to a reputable place. Number four is variability of response. And many people don't think about that, but if you have any type of treatment in your body, vitamins or a blood pressure drug or anything else, there's always fine tuning and variability of the body, and it changes over time. So the response several months ago to a treatment is going to inherently be different a few months down the road. There's just variability of the body, integration of the fillers, and medications patients might be on, or the state of their body at the time. Is it fatigued? Is the immune system amped up? Is it low? We're always changing, and so the body by nature has variable response to external stimuli, and that includes medication and implants such as fillers. So that's another variability. Number five, of course, is expectations. So when people need touch-ups, there's two things with expectations. Number one is it's never achieved. So the patient has something in their mind and they go home and it never was quite large enough, or it was too large, or it didn't quite last as long, okay? Or the fact is they get used to it. That's the second one. So they go home, I want one vial or 1.5 vials in the lip area. They see it, they love it. And then it forks, I think it all went away, I don't see much. The reality is they got used to it. It brings a lot of attention in, and then everyone's used to it, including the patient, and they want a little bit more. So expectations play a big role. So there's five reasons that touch-ups are normal. But I wanted to make that point that it's not a knee-jerk reaction that the provider did something wrong or didn't give enough. Understand all those five reasons are things that might change and might need a touch-up or a tune-up. It's very normal to have to go back. The 80-20 rule, think of that. So let us know what you think. Do you often have to go for touch-ups? Do you like to? A lot of patients like to fine-tune and make things perfect. Let us know in the comments below. Also join us over on Instagram. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.